More fun than movies, this is Trailer Told, a YouTube channel in the world. Thank you for clicking. Check out the playlist for a different video. Subscriptions are a big boost.
Vessel of Hatred is Diablo 4's first major expansion, where we will venture far into the dense jungles of Nahantu. It's an ancient place with a deep connection to the spirit realm, and it's here that we find our new class. The Spiritborn is an apex predator of the jungle, whose fighting style is swift, hard-hitting, and extremely agile. They are warriors with the ability to call massive spirit guardians directly into battle. Their speed in combat makes them one of the most mobile classes in the game, and their ability to blend powers from multiple spirit guardians makes them the most customizable as well. So without further ado, let's take a look at Diablo 4's all-new class, the Spiritborn.
There's a whole story to tell with these spirit guardians. It's a class that's so rooted in the world of Nahantu. They're able to connect with the spirit realm in a way that no other people have.
You call the spirit guardians into battle with you. They infuse all of your skills and you channel and fight alongside them.
I remember early in development, the class team coming to me so excited about this piece of concept art. It was a hero holding this quarterstaff high into the sky, and this massive spirit creature was rising up behind him. And that's where the Spiritborn began.
The Spirit Guardians are the four main spirits that the Spiritborn works with.
We have the eagle, the centipede, the jaguar, and the gorilla.
The eagle is mostly based around precision and impact and movement throughout the battlefield. They're really good at taking down priority targets and getting in and out of combat.
With the centipede, a lot of that is about crowd control. You have poison primarily that helps slowly over time kind of take them down and feed that poison into them.
The jaguar is a fire damage type, which if you think about fire, it's fast, it's ferocious, it's vicious.
It's all about that hard, swift, slashing, hitting action that you would expect from a predator, a hunter.
The gorilla is very defensive when you think of a tank type of class or a fighting style, that's the gorilla.
They're able to both take damage but also deal it back to anybody who hurts them.
I think we're covering a nice spectrum of themes going from the gorilla to the centipede. It gives players a lot to choose from.
Even though a lot of our powers are inspired from many classes that we've seen across the franchise, we really felt it was important to do something new.
The Spiritborn's playstyle is very unique because it's got the speed and the agility of the rogue, but it's also physically brutal, just like the barbarian. And that's all layered with these fantastical effects, very similar to the sorcerer.
Combat feels really important. It feels very different than any of the other classes, while still feeling very visceral and impactful.
You can assign skills for any of the spirit guardians to your skill bar, like maybe something from Jaguar that you want to hit quick and you want to hit hard, but you also want to have an option to defend yourself and maybe take a step back, so then you would choose something from the gorilla skill kit instead.
The Spiritborn's class mechanic is called the Spirit Hall. Players can choose from the four spirits to empower their skills with a passive ability that allows them to further customize their builds with devastating effects based on each spirit's core themes. There's a playstyle to fit anyone. If the lightning eagle really resonates, you can go full eagle, or you can mix and match and do whatever you like, depending on how you like to play.
The ultimates are all pretty amazing because you manifest the entire spirit into the world and they destroy everything for you while powering you up.
The centipede, for example, it bursts out of the ground. It's basically throwing poison everywhere and it just feels really awesome and it makes you feel insanely powerful.
The Spiritborn's bringing two new weapons to the game. The first one was the glaive. It's a double-bladed staff weapon that's very focused around heavy damage.
We chose the glaive because it lends itself well to the martial arts fighting style that the Spiritborn has.
The second new weapon that the Spiritborn is bringing is the quarterstaff. It's a very fast and very agile weapon. They're often punching or kicking their enemies, but if they want to extend themselves into battle, the glaive and the quarterstaff really allow them to do that. Along with these new weapon types, the Spiritborn will also have brand new legendary affixes to complement a player's preferred build and playstyle.
you're in combat, building up this momentum, gathering all the energy from these spirit creatures, and then unleashing those spirits upon the battlefield. It's such a good flow that you want to repeat that over and over again.
Each of the guardian spirits are infused with personality and different types of visuals. That ability to make your own version of a Spiritborn is a highlight that players will really enjoy.
As you see more of the story and understand why the Ancestry and the Spirit Guardians are so important to Spiritborn, seeing that tie in a very unique new way is going to be an exciting thing for players to experience.